This is the Stripinator wire stripping machine, model 945 by Bluerock Tools. This machine is our 230 volt machine. It does not come with a power cord, so it should be hooked up by a qualified electrician. As you can see here, there's a system of cutters and rollers. And there's actually two different assemblies. So there's a system of cutters and a system of rollers. Then underneath, there's another system of rollers and a set of cutters. So what this does is cuts the top and bottom of larger wires, and it cuts the top of smaller wires. So as you can see here, there's 14 channels. Two of the square channels here are for ROMEX or non-metallic coated wires. Go larger here. You can also see the a knurling on the system of rollers. This assists in pulling in different types of wire. This machine is spec'd to strip from 14 gauge up to 1¾ inch. It does, as it's the 230 version of this machine, it does have a 3 horsepower motor, 2.2 kilowatt. This machine has a system of pulleys, belts, gears, and chains, which drive the system of cutters and rollers. It has a magnetic motor starter. Then we have our side guards here, which cover our systems and belts. And we have our spring tensioner, which can be adjusted with the T-handles here. Basically, if you're cutting too much into the wire, you can let the adjusters off a little bit. If you're not quite cutting into the jacket enough, you can tighten them up. And yeah, so this is our model 945. We'll run a little bit of wire now through it for demonstration purposes. Okay, this is a 14 gauge THHN solid. A 12 gauge THHN solid. Okay, this is a 10 AWG stranded THHN. Copper. Okay, next piece we're gonna run is 750 MCM. It's close to 1¼ inches. If you're doing a lot of this larger size wire, it is a good idea to adjust the lower mandible bolts. So those are not these. These are the upper T-handle adjustments. They control the spring tension. The lower mandible bolts will actually raise the top cutter and roller assembly. And those bolts are down here, down below. They have little lock nuts on them, on both of them. So once you release the lock nuts, pull the lock nuts down a little bit, and then you'll turn these T-handles. And as you can see, that back assembly has raised. And then we'll do the front one here. And the front upper cutter is raising. I know it's kind of hard to see in the video, but what we've done is, in essence, give ourselves an extra 1/2 inch worth of room between our cutters and rollers on these larger channels. People generally will use this if they're doing a lot of the same size wire. If you're doing a lot of 500, a lot of 750, 1000, and you want to prolong your blade life, this is a good way. It just pretty much makes it not quite as much tension necessary to cut through the jacket. So now we've raised those. We'll go up here, loosen our spring tensioners a little bit, and all loose. And we'll run the 750. Okay, 750.
The ROMEX 14-2.